Yes, nice to see you once again. I welcome you once again, and I say that I love you all so much. I love you all so much. And if you're today is your first time of coming across my channel, I will advise you, if you want to know the truth, want to know what God is saying and what God is revealing about His body, the church, and about the whole world, you can still go ahead and subscribe. Touch that subscribe, see a place to subscribe. Just touch it, subscribe, and you will see something like a bell there. Touch it also once, just once, so that you keep on receiving a new video for you to be current, knowing what God is saying and what God is doing. So I welcome you once again. I promise to reveal something to you where Adeboye is taking your tithe that they are all shouting and the crying for you to be bringing, where he is taking his own tithe. Because you pay your tithe to him, he also has to go and give to the source where they are getting, where they get their power, where their power comes from. So you give to them, they also minus and go and give to the native doctor, or the Babalawo that is, pumping power to them. They also have to go and give to them. That's why they always cry and shout tithe, tithe, tithe. Any pastor is crying for tithe every time, tithe. They have a secret agenda that is behind it. Because our God, as I told you, our God doesn't spend money. Our God doesn't eat money. Heaven doesn't spend money. It's here on earth that money is needed. Me and you spend money, and money is just needed for the true man of God or men of God that is doing the work of God, for them to use the money to expand the gospel, to spread the gospel, not for their own private use, not for them to be living a flamboyant life, living the lifestyle of the people that is in the world that not know God. Money is needed in the kingdom of God for the advancement of the kingdom of God, for God's people to use it to glorify God. So God, our God, will never tell you that if not pay one tenth, if not sow seed, that he will not bless you, or he did not give, he will not bless you. God expects to give willingly, to give joyfully, for God loves a cheerful giver. He wants you to give in support of his kingdom, in support of the work of God, in joy, in happiness, not by force, not by threat, not by raising curses. Okay? So it's only the devil that needs that, that takes things by force, that force people to give, that puts fear for people to give. But God will convince you to say, give. Give, knowing that a giver never lacks. Without taking much of your time, as I said to you, if you love the channel, go ahead and subscribe and touch the notification bell. Then you keep on receiving new videos. All right, I want to tell you something now that will marvel you. During the time that a lost chosen, there's a time that it was exposed. That one woman that started the ministry, or that is not the lost chosen, that started that church with him, get up in a good day, and something happened. God wants to use that woman to open people's eyes. But I noticed that Nigeria or African people, they so much love lies, they so much love wickedness, they so much love evil. So God allowed the woman to speak out for a reason. The woman is called Chuzimopo. Many of you know the story. She explained, she exposed a lot of things about Lazarus Mocker of the lost chosen. But during that time, I was in Lagos, so the church dried up. That man's church, the lost chosen, dried up during that period of time that the woman chose to, get up to expose anything that is hidden in that church. The church dried up. So in the compound where I live, some of the members was busy defending the man, talking many things, saying all kinds of things. So I was hearing, so I get down, because I was staying upstairs, I get down. I call them. So I begin to expose a lot of things, like what I'm doing. I begin to expose a lot of things about Nigerian churches and Nigerian pastors, especially Pentecostal churches. So when I was exposing a lot of things, There is one pastor, a Yoruba man, a pastor. He's a pastor under Apostolic Church. So the man is also living in the same company, in the same compound. But I'm living upstairs. I'm staying upstairs. The man is staying downstairs. So he's a pastor, but the lifestyle of this man is not something to talk about here. His life is disgusting. His ways are dirty. This pastor of a apostolic church. He's a Yoruba man. He's from Yoruba. So when I was exposing some things about Nigerian churches, the pastor, you know, came out of his room. He came out. He was hearing what I'm saying. So after some time, he said that he wants to say something to the people. He wants to talk in the compound. He said he wants to say something. So he said that if people hear what I'm saying, and some people will think, because I also talk about Adeboye, I talk about many of them. The man said that if people that is hearing me now, that as they are hearing, they think maybe I'm just formulating things, that what I'm telling them, that he wants to contribute, he wants to say something about what I'm saying. So I stay quiet, so he begins to talk. He said that he's a Yoruba man, that he's a pastor, as they know in the compound. But something happened that one time somebody took him to a place, told him that if he really want to carry crowd, that he should come with him. So he said the person took him to one strong native doctor, a strong one in Yoruba land. So he told him that if he go to the man, that the Baba will make him to become rich and famous, like all the pastors, all the mega churches that he's seen in Nigeria, in Lagos State, in Lagos, in Nigeria today, that the Baba will make him to be famous, that the Baba Lawo made many of them to be famous, that he should go to the man, to the Baba Lawo. So he said, getting to the man, to the Baba Lawo, behold, he turned, he saw redeem sticker, their logo of a bed coming. You know, he saw the redeem Christian church. So the Baba began to tell him that, oh, I made so many people rich. Adeboye comes here, see the sticker of his church. He comes here to see me. He said, oh, that he also is one that made Lazarus Mocha to be famous, to be rich. That he's just he just do what he will tell him to do, and he will go ahead and become famous like other ones. So he now say, okay, what should I bring? So the Baba now told him many things that he will do and bring. He said that those things that he can't even say it. So he said that the Baba told him that Adeboye brings one tenth to him. And the Lord's choosing also bring one tenth to him. So he said that the Lord's choosing is that what happened to the Lord's choosing is he came for power. He came to him for power. So he told him, if you get home, just you will see, go to the backyard or no, the backyard where you're living, you will see an animal, just kill the animal. If you kill the animal, you see, you know, you will become rich and famous overnight. So he said, when he finished with the Lord's choosing, so the Lord's choosing get into his house, went to the backyard and saw the animal, standing there. So he killed the animal. Behold, as he killed the animal, the wife died immediately. The wife died. And you can remember that man, Lazarus Mocha, always said that God called him into ministry, but the wife was a hindrance. The wife was a hindrance, and he prayed and prayed, and God take away the wife. How can God kill your wife? How can your wife be a hindrance to God's call upon your life? And how can God take away your wife? How can God kill your wife? God called you, and your wife is a hindrance. I mean, I'm talking about the first wife, because after the first wife died, he married another woman. So many of them that you are seeing that is rich, mega churches, their first wife that have died. Many of them, their first wife died, and they go and marry the second woman. So the Baba, the pastor of that CEO in the company, begin to expose many things, don't talk a lot of many things, say that people respect this man, this Adeboye, so much, but they don't know that he's not a man of God. That the man is not a man of God. So he said that he fear what I'm saying, that the fear came upon him. That all that I'm saying, that if maybe he wanted to say, have I ever been to the man, to the Babalawo, where they are taking the tithe and all that? How did I know all these things? The man said that he become afraid. that he has to get up from his bed, as he's hearing what I'm saying, that this thing is not ordinary. It's not maybe, I didn't know this thing ordinary, that there is a spirit, that the spirit of the Most High God have revealed this to me. The man said that he respect me and he feared me, and he feared me. He feared what I'm busy from the man, that he's afraid of me. So I know him. Even the man did not continue going to do the ritual. He messed his life up. His life is smelling. The pastor, you know, of the apostolic church, he said that he ran away. He did not go and continue. His life is smelling, totally messed up. Okay, so I just want to let you know about this, because so many of them, all that they will do, they will shout, pay tithe. Because the more you pay your tithe, they will take it to the native doctor, to the Babalawo, where they get their power, where they're pumping their power to them. And once you take it there, your life is gone, your destiny is gone. They use it to remote control, to know each money that they bring, they use it to remote the members. I know the one with destinies. They take it, they took it away, and you want to sacrifice and many things. So these people are not serving God. The way they cry, they are crying about tithe. Ashimalowo crying there, going from one place to another, crying. Adeboye. And they don't have biblical verse to defend or chapter to defend what they are saying. There's no place in the Bible that God said you must pay one tenth, you must pay one tenth, you must. And even one tenth is Old Testament issue, and it is not everybody that pays tithe in the Old Testament. So the New Testament is all about giving. After Christ came, after he died, everything about New Testament is giving. Give, it shall be given back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men pour into your bosom. So when you give to God with a pure heart, with a joyful heart, God keep blessing you. Not by force. Without your giving, God will keep on being God. God is God. Because God is not dependent on your money. God is already God. But when you are doing things for his kingdom, for the advancement of his kingdom, his blessing keep flowing in your life. Not only money, but giving service, pure service to his kingdom is all about New Testament. Giving your money, giving your time, giving everything that God has given to you, giving the best to his service, to his kingdom, is all that God is talking about. Not one tenth, not so seed, not this and that, threatening and all that. Tell them to stop shouting tithe, that you are no more interested in giving them your money, because they are using it to destroy your life. They are giving your money to the devil, and the devil is using to operate in your life, in your finances, controlling you, destroying your life. So I want to let you know this, because what I just listed to you now is nothing but the truth. They are not men from God, they are men from the devil. So God bless you, really good. So say you in a hurry. So say you, I am going for something now, and as I still have to do this video now, I want to say bye-bye, and I love you all. God bless you. Bye.